Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Coders Arcade. In this tutorial video, I will teach you how to install the tools required to build Java applications in our system. So let's get started. First of all, let us go to our browser and here we will search for JDK download. So JDK, the full form of JDK is Java Development Kit, and now I'll press enter, and you can see it takes us to the link, which is Java SE. SE is called Standard Edition. It is supported by Oracle. Let us go to this website, and when I open it, you can see it says Java Standard Edition. So here you have to click on this link, JDK download, and I'm clicking on it, and as you can see, it takes me to the download space, and here I have to search for the JDK version for my operating system. Right now I'm using the Windows operating system, so as I scroll down, you can see I will have the versions for different operating systems, and I am searching for the Windows version. As you can see here, it says Windows x64 installer. So here, this is the one I'm looking for, the exe file. I will click on this, and as soon as I click on it, it asks me to accept the license agreement. So I will click this checkbox, and here I can start the download. So as you can see here, the download has started, and it will take certain amount of time depending on the internet speed that you are using. So in the meantime, let me tell you about this JDK. This JDK is the Java Development Kit, with the help of which you will have the Java compiler, and you will also be having the JVM, which is the Java Virtual Machine, with the help of which we can convert Java codes to bytecode. And now bytecode is one more thing, with the help of which we can convert the Java program and make it compatible to any operating systems. We will be discussing a lot more about these things in the upcoming videos. So right now, as you can see, the JDK installation file has been downloaded. I will just click on this, and it's opening. So let me just minimize this page. So here you can see it's getting installed. So it will take a certain amount of time depending on the speed of your computer. So here I will click next, and it is trying to install Java Standard Edition Development Kit in the C program files. If you want to install it into any other folder, you have to click on this change option, and I will do it for you. I can show you how it can be done. So you can just change this here. I will keep it to, say, my E drive. So I'll press OK. So now you can see I have manually changed the destination folder, and now I'll click on next, and now it has started the installation process. So as you can see, it's getting installed. So here you can see that it has got installed Java TM SE Development Kit 16.0.1. successfully installed, as you can see here. Now I will just close it, and after we have installed the Java JDK, we will require an editor or an IDE to write our Java programs. And let me tell you the full form of IDE. It is known as Integrated Development Environment, with the help of which we can write our Java programs and run them or execute them. So the best known IDEs for Java are NetBeans, Eclipse, and IntelliJ IDEA. So I will be using IntelliJ IDEA because it is one of the best known IDEs for Java, and it is totally dedicated for Java. That's why it is one of the best. And it doesn't matter, you can use NetBeans or Eclipse or any other IDE as well for the tutorial. It doesn't matter. but I will be using IntelliJ IDEA for my case. So let me go to my browser once again, and here in a new tab I will search for IntelliJ IDEA. So here you can see it takes me to the link IntelliJ IDEA, the capable and ergonomic Java IDE by JetBrains. So it has been designed by JetBrains. Let me click on this link. And here you can see this is the download option which I'm getting here. So I will click on this download link. And we will be downloading the community version, which is the free version, and it is enough for our purpose. So I'll click on this download link, and you can see it is getting downloaded. It will take some time depending on the size. The size is around 644 MB, as you can see here. So with the help of this IntelliJ IDEA IDE, as you can see here, we will be writing our codes and we will be executing them one by one. So you can see it's almost done. So yeah, the IntelliJ exe file has been downloaded. So I'll click on it, and you can see it's starting the setup here, and go on to next. It's a pretty easy installation, you know, don't need to worry about this. So as you can see here, my destination folder is C. So what I will do is I will just change it to E. So I will then click on next, and let me create the 32-bit launcher for desktop. And so you don't have to do anything else, and you can just click on next and click on install. So now you can see it's getting installed. It will take certain amount of time. So you can see here the installation is almost done. So let me just do one thing. I'll click on this run IntelliJ IDEA community edition. Then I will click on finish. So you can see it's prompting me with the user agreement. So I will click on this confirm, and I will click on continue. So it's asking me for data sharing. I will just click on don't send. And as you can see here, this is the IntelliJ IDEA IDE for Java. And here you can see the version. It is a community version as we downloaded, and the version is 2021.1. So this is the welcome screen of IntelliJ IDEA. As you can see here, this is the option for creating a new project. As you can see here, plus button, and then you have this open to open some existing projects. So in the next video, we will be learning how to create projects and how to write our first program in IntelliJ IDEA. So stay tuned. And also like, share and subscribe to our channel Coders Arcade. Thank you.
So this is all about this video, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you like the video, and if you like it, then tell us in the comment section below. If you have any doubts, then post them in the comment section. I will definitely try to clear those doubts. Also like, share and subscribe to our channel Coders Arcade, and press the bell icon so that you will get a notification when we post a new video. Thank you. Happy learning.